Okay. Whole new metagame. Well, not whole new, but it's a new metagame. All right, Sam, what are the big players in the current modern metagame?
Well, if you look at the Pro Tour results, you might think it's only Affinity and Eldrazi, but there were a few other decks that ended up doing quite well. One that got me pretty excited was Ari Lax and a couple other of the Team Ultra Pro guys played Malira Collected Company, which that's right up my alley.
definitely.
Ari said he thought that he was pretty favored against the Eldrazi because Chalice isn't very good against him, and you could usually get it, you know, block and get yourself in such a way that you get a turn four, and by around turn four you should be able to combo with the Malira because the Eldrazi deck doesn't actually have a lot of ways to kill a creature. So, you know, if you can get that Malira, Anafenza, Kitchen Finks out, you should be good to go. Another good finisher was Sam Black, went also 8-2, I think, with Lantern Control.
Oh, yeah, it's a real deck, Mashi.
Yeah, not a deck you necessarily want to be one of the good decks in the format, but our deck has a really hard time beating Ensnaring Bridge.
Yeah.
All the Eldrazi decks do, so.
Yeah, Lantern Control might be a good choice.
That could be a good choice for sure.
Oh, that seems like a miserable grind at a tournament, though.
Well, yeah. I mean, obviously you have Eldrazi as like the top dog. If you ever, you know, play in any tournament, everybody's going to be looking to build this deck. And, you know, there are a few strategies, though, that do work against the Eldrazi deck. It is not an unbeatable deck. You know, a lot of people are taking out their pitchforks. They're like, all right, well, when's the next ban update? When are we going to ban this deck? Because it's just too powerful. And I think, you know, you just give Modern a little bit of time and, you know, see, you know, what other decks pop up as a result of,
right,
you know, the success in the Eldrazi deck. Because the Eldrazi deck does have its weaknesses as well.
Well, and I think it's important, and it's funny because I see that too. Obviously, social media, during the Pro Tour, after the Pro Tour, every social media outlet talks about, oh my gosh, it's Modern is awful. This is why Modern is so bad. I can't believe we just did this. Just look at the Pro Tour.
Well, Owen did write an article about why Modern is terrible.
I thought he wrote an article about why it shouldn't be a Pro Tour format.
Yeah, that's what it was.
Yeah,
that's what it
was. But the other way to look at that too, though, is okay. There's a new metagame. Now go out there and break it. You know, you can look at where the Pro Tour is at as okay. That's it. The pros figured it out. That's the whole metagame. Our job here is done, but there's a whole new metagame out there. Like in Staring Bridge, we just talked about it. Staring Bridge is pretty freaking good against Eldrazi.
The thing is, this with Magic players, a lot of people don't like change, and this is a pretty big change, right? You have this deck that's great against a lot of the top decks in the format, and now, I mean, it's going to shake up the metagame, right? Like, you know, for example, right now, the colorless Eldrazi deck is likely not a great choice. Because if you play the colorless Eldrazi deck and you run up against the blue-red Eldrazi deck, which a lot of people are also going to try to play, you're going to be a pretty big dog, right? You know, if you see a lot of Affinity players, I think that's actually kind of a close matchup, you know, given that both Shuhei and Luis defeated an Affinity deck now in the top eight. And there's a lot of other decks. For example, I tried playing Living End. I was like, well, you know, I did a little bit of testing against the deck, and I was like, Living End actually seems like a pretty good strategy because they're a creature-based strategy. They have minimal amount of disruption. They're no longer playing the 4x Relic of Progenitus package in the main deck, and you know all you're going to do is just cycle a bunch of cards and put a bunch of good big creatures into play. So I fully expect you know various strategies to arise. You know tier two strategies in order like to try to fight this deck. And I think Living End, Lantern Control, those are kind of like two decks that have a pretty good matchup against this deck.
And that's your job. That's everybody's job out there. Like new metagames are like the rogue's paradise. Play, tinker, test, and break it again and break it again. And so like that's when I see something like this, and I don't think the deck is somehow so oppressive that there aren't ways to build around it or build with it or build in that metagame. So is the Pro Tour the end of the metagame or the beginning of the metagame? And it's just a matter of how you kind of approach it. That being said, do you think, Sam, there needs to be a change? Should Wizards, I actually posted this Twitter poll on Twitter. Do you think that Wizards should be banning something? Do you think Wizards needs to unban something? Or do you think Wizards just needs to kick back, relax, and take it easy?
I think there's probably room for some unbannings. I don't know if they're necessary per se, but like right now, if Bloodbraid Elf or Ancestral Vision had been legal at this Pro Tour, I don't think anything would have changed for us. Like, you suspend an Ancestral Vision, that's no guarantee that you're going to survive until that thing comes off, or that we won't just play a Chalice for zero and counter it anyway. So I think there's definitely some cards that could see unbanning. I think it's a little premature to ban something because, like, as Paul was saying, like, yeah, Living End, Malira, Ensnaring Bridge decks, you have room to build your deck to try and fight this. And I think we should give people some time to see how that goes at GP Detroit.
Paul, how about you? You think anything needs to be unbanned?
Anything needs to be unbanned. Yeah, Splinter Twin, obviously.
Really?
Yeah. What's wrong? I never thought Splinter Twin was, like, too oppressively good. I mean, it was a fine deck. It was a good deck.
We got this great deck.
I mean, like, you have Affinity that's legal. You can make an argument for Affinity.
But think about what this banning did. This top eight is so different, potentially, because of this banning. Because everyone started looking at other things when we started to get this Eldrazi.
Yeah, but the thing is, I think the Eldrazi strategy is so powerful, even with Splinter Twin in the format, mm-hmm. the Eldrazi deck would be a deck. It just wouldn't be nearly as dominant of a deck, which is a nice thing. You know, you have kind of all these other decks keeping, you know, each other in check. And I think Splinter Twin was, like, a pretty good deck at doing that.
Could the Eldrazi take down Jace the Mind Sculptor?
Well, I'm still, like, let's not have Jace be unbanned.
Dude, Planeswalkers are pretty vulnerable to creature damage.
I mean...
Pardee, can the Eldrazi Menace take down Jace the Mind Sculptor?
I guess Reality Smasher matches up pretty well against him, but I would be pretty scared of that one.
Yeah, I mean, the thing is, you just played on turn 5 with a Path to Exile or something.
Yeah.
You know, it's like they're just... You can play it, bounce down, not to your draw card. Like,
he even draws you an extra card to discard to the Reality Smasher.
Yeah.
How many turns do you get with Eldrazi? If your strategy is your turn 5 Jace the Mind Sculptor, that's
well, yeah,
how you're
but when you're building a Jace the Mind Sculptor deck, that's the top of your curve. Like, you're playing a bunch of nice, cheap, interactive spells mm-hmm. to get to Jace and have Jace take over with your Snapcaster Mages and cheap removal spells and cheap counters. So, presumably, when you play against this Eldrazi deck, you're just going to have a lot of cheap ways to kill their creatures, and then you play Jace and win the game.
Hmm. I'm a little bit more skeptical. I think, for once, I'm actually like... I know I love to say if Bloodbraid were in, but for once I actually am starting to think, wait a minute.
No Jace.
I think Jace could be held in check by the Eldrazi Menace.
But I do think Splinter Twin would be completely
Well, fun. We all know that. Check out the videos on Channel Fireball.
Yeah.
Come on.
Like, yeah, they were fun matches.
All right, yeah. Sam.
Sam, unfortunately for me, Sam plays Splinter Twin a lot, so he, like, knows exactly what my mana base is like.
Mm-hmm.
I enjoyed Ghost Quarter against Paul.
God, because I'm not. You're just not used to playing a deck that has four Ghost Quarters in it. Mm-hmm. So, like, usually one is okay, but when they draw two, it's actually a problem.
Sam, if Wizards were to decide, oh my gosh, we need to do something, we need to ban something, what would be kind of the dagger in the heart?
I think either Eldrazi Temple or Iavugan, and I would guess they would go with Eldrazi Temple because Iavugan is. Sort of a legitimate card in Tron.
Yeah, it's very good as a one of.
And that's it. If Temple goes out, the deck's done.
I think the deck would still be good or
I
solid.
Think it would be okay, but it would be pretty tough to really pull the trigger. Like Reality Smasher, when you're paying a full, even if you're only paying 4 mana, that's still a pretty hefty cost.
Yeah, it's true.
So would it even be tier 1?
I don't know. I would have to play a lot to find out. I think it would still be okay, but we probably wouldn't have played it at this Pro Tour, for example.
Yeah, it seems like it would have been crazy. All right, Paul, tomorrow you're showing up to the next Pro Tour. It's Modern. What's your 75?
I would likely play Living End.
Living End, right?
If I expect a larger percentage of Eldrazi because, like, knowing that, like, if Eldrazi is a big part of the metagame moving forward.
Which tomorrow, yeah. I think it would be.
Yeah, yeah. Tomorrow maybe Eldrazi is like 15% of the field, which is really high, maybe 10%. I mean, I think I was already...
I think it would be 15.
Yeah, I thought, like I said before, Living End was already kind of on my radar going into the Pro Tour, and if Eldrazi was going to be a good portion of the field, I think it would be a pretty solid choice.
Sam, same question. Sleeve up your 75. What do you got there?
I think I'd play Malira. I've had success with that.
You know what? I knew
it. Why'd you even ask that?
I knew it. I knew he was going to say Malira. I just knew. I don't know.
You're also good against Infect.
So I should have just been like, so Sam, how's that Malira deck going to treat you at the tournament?
Exactly.
So awesome. Any final thoughts on our new Eldrazi Overlords or Pro Tour Oath of the Gatewatch, Sam?
It was a lot. It was so much fun to have the whole team winning. John Stern keeps a notebook. With like a little graph in it every round of each person's record so we can go through and look. And so, you know, you'd look every round and be like, oh, we went 13-3 this round, excluding our matches against teammates. And that was just awesome.
Yeah.
Like, it's fun to win yourself, and it's so much more fun when also all of your friends are winning.
Yeah.
Paul,
yeah.
Any other final thoughts?
No, I share the exact same sentiment. You know, I know I wasn't able to, like, meet up with these guys, but, you know, most of these guys are my friends. And just seeing everybody just, you know, be so excited, because there's so few people that were actually just doing poorly. You know, every time, you know, around them, you're like, how'd you do? I won. This deck is busted. How'd you do? I won. This deck is busted. And, you know, just being able to share that all together and just having the success of this deck, it just really brought everybody, like, up together. I really, really enjoyed this Pro Tour. And you'll see it in the Chlog.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to the Chlog. Congratulations to you both. This is one of the most dominant team finishes. It's probably the most dominant in recent memory. It's one of the most dominant team finishes ever. Really in large part, Sam, to you and Jacob, who probably are not getting enough credit for finding this deck, tuning this deck, developing this deck. And then I know what team politics are like, selling this deck to get these guys to consider it. You know, because let's be honest, it looks like you just took a bunch of your leftover draft decks and decided you were going to play Modern with it, right?
Well, I mean, look at Lantern Control, look at Blue, right? Mm-hmm. When you first look at those decks, you're just like, I don't get it.
But this looks like I went out there and bought a booster box, and the challenge for this Pro Tour is I'm going to build my constructed deck from all the cards.
I disagree. I think you get that from Lantern, because that's literally just a pile of garbage commons and uncommons.
Uh-huh.
This one, it's kind of like Mirrodin, right? You have this affinity that you have all these cards that work super well together and has great synergy, and maybe the last four cards don't have so much synergy because we ran out of great colorless cards to play in the deck.
We had to bring some cards.
But I really do think, I mean, this kind of reminds me of, you know, kind of this block just, you know, presented you this entire deck, mm-hmm. right? Kind of like Mirrodin.
No, it served it up affinity. For sure. Fair enough, yeah. But... Nevertheless, Sam, you and Jacob were able to sell a seemingly innocuous pile of draft cards.
There were definitely some comments in the team forums like, this deck is unplayable.
Yeah.
I don't think anyone's going to play this.
And thank you so much for overcoming that. What an amazing finish. Congratulations to you both. Thank you guys for watching. All we have left now is our first top 8.